What's up, everybody? My name's Fall from Grace, and today I just wanted to do a really quick demo of the new NVIDIA Broadcast Eye Contact Beta. So I've seen quite a few people post this, but they have all been male presenting. So I wanted to see how this worked on myself as a makeup wearer and as a woman. And one thing that I'm noticing as soon as I look away, you can see around the eyelid, around when I put my finger in it, that is so janky. But when you look around this section, around the eyelashes, it is definitely quite noticeable. It's definitely not perfect when you look at the comparison between the two. It looks a little bit off. And I also feel like the AI version, the eye contact version, definitely looks unnatural. The eyes seem a little bit more mattified. They're not quite as glossy and not quite as alive. But obviously this is just a beta and this is like maybe a first version. So I'm looking forward to seeing how this can progress. So one thing I wanted to test is reading a quick script, because that's where I think this is going to be very useful. So this will be a small section of a script that I wrote for Elgato, and I'm looking at it on my monitor that's just underneath my camera. The difference between professionals and everything else is often just the small details. So here's something small you can do to make your podcast, streaming, and work from home setup way more pro. Some other cases I can see this being very useful for is when you're doing work from home or in meetings, and you want to make sure that you're engaging the person that you're talking to, but you can still kind of be looking off screen to make sure that you're on topic. It's definitely interesting and it's kind of funny to play with. If I look too far off to the side, you can see the eyes kind of like, I'm not looking at the lens whatsoever, and seeing it like pop on and off is kind of unsettling because I know that I'm not looking at the lens. So seeing the preview and seeing myself with this like intense eye contact is a bit weird. But I definitely think it's going to be one of those things that you notice more as the person, knowing that that's not exactly what your eyeballs look like, but the average viewer probably wouldn't notice. And one other thing I wanted to test for my glasses wearers out there is how it handles glasses being on. So I'm expecting these at this angle. It's actually handling it pretty well, and I feel like it may even look better with the glasses on because it does kind of hide that weird bit around the eyelashes. But if you've got glare, it might mess, or it definitely messes with it if there's glare. And yeah, obviously if you look too far off to the side, it's just gonna completely cancel out because it would look super unnatural if it was like dead eye contact when you're looking away like that. And obviously if you try to completely obstruct it, it's just gonna stop altogether, and you will get a second where you can see the AI eyes right there. So my thoughts, I definitely think it's going to be a useful tool once it's dialed in a little bit more. It's probably fine for the average person, but I feel like for me, it definitely isn't looking natural enough to the point that I would feel comfortable in using it. But once it gets a little bit better, I think it's gonna be great. But I'd love to know what you think. I need to remember as well to be looking away from it because that's the whole point. But let me know down in the comments what you think of this eye contact NVIDIA beta. If you want to try it out for yourself, you just need to download the NVIDIA broadcast software, and you'll need to obviously have an NVIDIA graphics card, and I believe it's a 2060 or higher. But that is all for this video today. I'd love to know what you think down in the comments. Let me know if you think this looks natural, if you see yourself using it, or if you think it's just super weird looking. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.